2009年 KSW インターナショナルミドル級王者マーメイブラバカ所属Sasaki Yuki。
So all's in readiness for this middleweight contest between Mamed Khalidov and Yuki Sasaki. Khalidov comes in as the favorite, minus 410. Sasaki at plus 310. It was Sasaki who weighed in slightly heavier, 184.3. Khalidov at 184 even at yesterday's public weigh-in and press conference.
My guess is this one got out of the first round. Khalidov comes off, he has a very high rate when he starts and tends to overwhelm most of his opponents.
Frank Trigg stares into the crystal ball, and here we go. Michael Chavello, Hans Thompson, and Franco Trigo with you. A must-win fight for Yuki Sasaki, who was inspired to become a fighter after watching Royce Gracie at the very first UFC. Back in 1993, he was 19 years old at the time. And after that, he ventured to Thailand on his own to train in Muay Thai. He's ended up here at Soul of Fight at the Ariake Coliseum in a career make or break match.
Oh,
nicely done. Gets the takedown off the leg kick of Khalidov.
The best chance for Saki to win is to end up on top. That was his best spot, and it worked out so far. This I did not anticipate. Khalidov doesn't do much from the bottom. He kind of holds on, tries to ride out.
Khalidov just controlling the posture here of Sasaki.
He won't have a very active guard, but he will keep active with his hands, Khalidov. But Sasaki isn't very good at ground and pound, but better at passing, but he's got to get up, guys got to head up and get moving. Keep your hand on the guy's chest. It's going to be a difficult day to try to get past anybody's guard.
Locking down that right wrist here of Yuki Sasaki. Sasaki originally from Hokkaido. He moved to Tokyo to train in grappling, where he met Sanae Kukuta and later helped to form the Grabaka Gym that has produced so many great Japanese fighters over the years. Khalidov throws the legs up.
See, Sasaki's got to posture up. He's got his head down, his hands aren't really moving. He's got to posture up, get himself up, sit up a little bit. Start to work and pass his guard.
Khalidov, who lost in March to George Santiago at SRC 12, was his first loss in over 5 years after having beaten Santiago in their previous contest. There is blood coming from somewhere on Yuki Sasaki.
My guess is a nose, Michael. He got hit pretty hard earlier.
And he eats a heel. Beautifully done from Khalidov. There's the right hand. Is it the beginning of the end, as Frank Trigg predicted here? Khalidov like a house on fire, pounding away. Sasaki taking enormous punishment. It's good night, Irene. Frank Trigg, you did it again, brother.
Does that mean I get a raise now? Because I keep guessing how these fights are going to go.
That is why best in the business, Frank. You called it. Khalidov with the knockout in the first round.
Sasaki's got a good submission game. He's got a good game to pass the guard. Sasaki could have taken him down, passed his guard if he had postured up and had a shot of catching something on the way in. But Khalidov starts off with such a high rate. He comes in so quick and so hard. A lot of guys get overwhelmed. This is what happened tonight. Again, that's what happened the first time he beat Santiago. He just overwhelmed him, but he didn't know what to do with himself.
Let's take a look at it again. The man with the 5 day growth just went to town on Yuki Sasaki. It started there, the beginning of the end, the beautiful up kick to the jawline. And from here it was all Khalidov, Frank.
And just rains down these punches, picks his spot, doesn't, you know, punches straight, but also punches hooks to get around the double forearm guard. Finally finds his spot. And once you hit him once with these little small gloves, a guy's guard is going to really open up wide. There's no way to stop it.
Look at that.
Until the ref gets in the way. Man.
Look at the up kick here. Boom.
One and another one. He comes off the rope and gets caught again. Double up kick. He got caught with the left foot and he got caught with the right foot.
And how quick was Khalidov to get back to his feet, drop the right hand, and then just pounce on Sasaki.
Very athletic, very quick. I like the way he moves. I like the way his sense too of guarding up and holding when he's on the bottom when he's in the submission game, and they changed it up to get back to striking, which is where he's most comfortable.
We'll be right back with more HDNet Fights.